Stroke is in the family of cardiovascular diseases and is number 5 cause of death and a leading cause of disability in the United States. In this video, we will be differentiating between the two main types of strokes and identifying symptoms of each. We will also list risk factors for developing a stroke and discuss complications that can occur. A stroke is a disruption in blood flow to the brain or a bleeding on the brain. It is a life-threatening emergency that needs immediate attention. There are two primary types of stroke. Hemorrhagic stroke occurs when a weakened blood vessel ruptures, often due to an aneurysm or artery malformation. Ischemic stroke occurs as a result of an obstruction within a blood vessel that supplies blood to the brain. It is the most common type, accounting for 87% of all stroke cases. A transient ischemic attack known as a TIA is a temporary clot in the brain, often called a mini stroke. A stroke has some very distinct symptoms, which is demonstrated with the FAST acronym. Check the face. Is it drooping? Is the person unable to raise both of their arms? Is their speech slurred, or are they unable to understand what you are saying to them? If the answer is yes to any of these questions, seek medical attention right away. Other symptoms may also occur, such as confusion, sudden severe headache, dizziness, trouble walking, and trouble seeing out of one or both eyes. If the brainstem is affected, paralysis can also occur. As mentioned previously, a TIA is a temporary clot in the brain that usually resolves within a few minutes. It is also a sign that a larger stroke may be imminent. Studies estimate that the risk of having a major stroke is 12 to 20% higher during the 3 months after a TIA. The symptoms of a brainstem stroke are more serious and complex than other types. The brainstem is responsible for controlling all the basic activities of the central nervous system, such as consciousness, breathing, blood pressure, swallowing, speech, heartbeat, eye movements, and hearing. Therefore, a brainstem stroke poses danger to important body functions, thus making it a life-threatening condition. Many of the risk factors for heart disease are the same for stroke, such as obesity, unhealthy diet, smoking, diabetes, high blood pressure, family history, and inactivity. Women are at slightly higher risk of stroke than men, and use of oral contraceptives and hormone replacement therapy can increase the risk. Some of the most common risk factors for stroke will be discussed in more detail. Like it is with heart disease, smoking is a major risk factor for stroke. Smokers are 6 times more likely to have a stroke than non-smokers and are also more likely to die if they do have a stroke. Smoking narrows the arteries to your brain, causing them to become blocked. This causes a stroke that can result in permanent paralysis, inability to speak, disability, or death. High blood pressure is the leading cause of stroke, causing more than half of strokes. Experts say that 80% of strokes can be prevented, and the single best way to prevent a stroke is to get your blood pressure down to 120 over 80 or less. Hypertension puts your arteries under constant stress. Too much force inside your blood vessels can weaken them over time. Chronic hypertension can increase the risk for both ischemic and hemorrhagic stroke. An estimated 15% of strokes are a result of untreated atrial fibrillation, known as AFib. But most people don't know what AFib is, much less know if they have it. AFib occurs in an estimated 2.7 million Americans and is the most common type of irregular heartbeat. AFib dramatically increases the risk of stroke, approximately 5 times over the general population. Stroke can cause temporary or permanent complications and is the leading cause of disability in the U.S. In the presence of paralysis, the individual is more likely to experience pneumonia, urinary infections, pressure sores, pulmonary embolism, blood clots, and constipation due to inactivity. Eating is also affected through loss of mobility to shop and prepare meals, as well as the ability to feed oneself. Adaptive equipment, as shown in the pictures, can be used to provide some independence and improve oral intakes. Cognitive and psychological problems can occur as well. Dysphagia occurs in more than half of the people who have had a stroke, and this can increase the risk of aspiration, pneumonia, dehydration, and aspiration. You may notice the similarities in risk factors with strokes, atherosclerosis, and high blood pressure. The good news is that means the same prevention factors with nutrition and lifestyle will improve risk of all three conditions. Complications and strokes are quite complex due to the multifaceted nature of the brain. As you consider the effects on a person's life, think about how food intakes and feeding will be altered.